I'm here with Bowie today, my Brazilian rainbow boa. So she isn't full grown right now. She's still growing, almost there. Her head is still gonna get much larger and she's gonna get longer, but she's pretty much a juvenile right now. She's about 2 years old and these guys take a very, very long time to grow. They are very, very small as babies, and then you're gonna have them for probably like 2 to 3 years before they're full grown. So today I'm going to be jumping into the care for Brazilian rainbow boas. Whenever I post Bowie on Instagram, people just go nuts because they love her so much. The iridescence on Brazilian rainbow boas is the one thing that makes them stand out the most. I'm not sure if it's picking up in this video, but they just have all of these colors, and in different types of light, mainly sunlight, they just pop and it's amazing. It's just one of the most spectacular things you'll ever see. So Brazilian rainbow boas aren't really listed for beginners, and that's mainly because they do have a little bit more strict of care, and that's mainly due to the high humidity that these guys require. They do need a very, very high humidity, especially as babies. A baby Brazilian rainbow boa is going to need 80 to 90% humidity, which seems insane, but it's very necessary. These snakes can get dehydrated and pass away, so you don't want that to happen. So you need to be very careful and understand how to maintain a snake like this just to make sure that they're always hydrated and that humidity level is up. Something that I did with Bowie when he was a baby was I had him in a little tank because he was obviously a smaller little snake at that point. He had a very large water bowl and I use Eco Earth for him. It works really great. It retains the humidity and as well as misting. I mist his enclosure down. It's best to do it at nighttime. If you have to do it in the morning, if it dries out, do it again. There should be a little bit of a dry period, especially with the adults. The adults don't need as high of a humidity level. So the babies do need the 80 to 100%. But then when they're adults, it goes down to 50 to 70%, which is still pretty high, but it's something you want to keep an eye on. So again, I use Eco Earth, a large water bowl, and when Bowie was a baby, I actually would put a towel on top of the screen enclosure, the top part of the tank, and that would hold in a lot of the humidity, and it always kept it very moist. And I'm sorry I have to use that word, and I probably just made a ton of people cringe because they hate the word moist, but it's very necessary for these guys, so I have to say it. So another thing with Brazilian rainbow boas is the fact that they do get kind of big. They do get 5 to 6 feet long, so that's something to keep in mind. They don't get as thick as boa constrictors. They are a little bit thinner of a snake, and Bowie right here is still going to get a little bit thicker than this. She's pretty thick, but she, again, is still growing. So Brazilian rainbow boas are absolutely amazing eaters. I've heard some people have had some issues, but it really just depends on the snake. Generally, they're great eaters. They do not refuse a meal. Bowie has never refused a meal other than this past spring. She actually didn't eat for, I think, a month or two. No. How long did you not eat? She actually didn't eat for a whole month, and that was because she is now getting to be very big, and that's very common for them to go off of feeding during the breeding season, so that's just a new thing that I had to adjust to with her, and then after that month she started eating just fine again. So when feeding a Brazilian rainbow boa, just like any other snake, you want to feed them a meal that is the size of the thickest part of their girth. So basically that means that the thickest part of the snake is exactly the size mouse that you want to be feeding them. You don't want anything to be smaller or bigger, you just want it to fit their girth perfectly as best you can. And you're going to be feeding your Brazilian rainbow boa once a week. I pick one specific day a week and that's feeding day, and that's what I've been doing this entire time. So when you're setting up an enclosure for a Brazilian rainbow boa, the babies obviously can be in a smaller tank. You can also do a racking system. I just prefer tanks because I'm a visual person. I like to see the snake and enjoy the snake and create a cool environment for them. But you don't have to do that. It's totally up to you. You do want to make sure, just like many other snakes, that you do have a warm spot and a cool spot of the enclosure, as well as a large water bowl. So for the water bowl size, you want to make sure that it's something that they can completely submerge in, that can help with shedding. I find that with Brazilian rainbow boas, just because you're keeping that humidity up so high for them, that they never ever have any issues with shedding, but it's good to offer that large water bowl because that will also increase the humidity level, and they need something fresh to drink as well. I use Repti Safe for my water that I give to Bowie, and that's something that you guys should do too. You just don't want there to be any chlorine in the water whatsoever, so Repti Safe works perfectly. You just put a couple drops in and you're set to go. So in a Brazilian rainbow boa enclosure, you do want to make sure that you have a hot spot, and the hot spot should be 80 to 85 degrees. You do not want to exceed that. These snakes actually prefer cooler temperatures compared to most other snakes. So you really want to modify the temperature in your enclosure. Make sure that the hot spot doesn't exceed 85 degrees whatsoever. And then on the cool side of the enclosure, it can go down to like 75 degrees. And they can also have a drop at night too, just like any other animal. You don't need any special lighting for these animals, no UVB, and the heat I find works best using a heat pad. Snakes need the underbelly heat in order to digest their food. So I don't think you should be using any overhead lighting because that can stress the snake out, especially because they are nocturnal. So that's something that I would avoid, and that's how I keep Bowie. Right now I actually have Bowie in a very, very large, I think it's the largest Exoterra that you can possibly get. It's extremely tall and it's very wide. It doesn't have enough floor space that I would like for her right now, so I'm actually going to be getting her a new enclosure this weekend, and I may update you guys in a video and let you know how that's going with her new enclosure. But basically the enclosure I have now, I offered a lot of height because they are semi-arboreal, and I thought that she would like to climb around and such, but honestly I think I found her climbing around on the branches maybe twice ever. So she is always burrowed. She usually just goes underneath her water bowl. I don't know why, but that's just her favorite spot to be. And I find that a lot of people that keep them, theirs do the same exact thing. They just really like the cooler temperatures, so that's what they usually do. So that's just what they do. And I don't really need the tall enclosure for Bowie anymore, so I'm gonna get a 4x2x2, and that'll fit her much better. She'll have more floor space to move around, and she doesn't really use the branches, although I may add some branches just for her to climb on just in case, but again, she probably won't use them, but it's nice to offer something just in case. So when it comes to the handleability for Brazilian rainbow boas, Bowie has always been very, very nice. He is a she, I need to get that through my brain. But she's always been very, very nice, even as a baby. That's what drew me to her, because she was my first snake. I wasn't very comfortable with snakes. I had a ball python temporarily that was literally the devil, and then Bowie was just this little angel, and she just changed everything for me. But the babies are actually known to be very, very feisty, and they're like little pistols. They love to bite. But with time, not even that much time, if you just keep handling and working with them, they realize you aren't a threat anymore, and they are very, very nice snakes. So as long as you work with your Brazilian rainbow boa, there really shouldn't be a problem. I find that Bowie is pretty food aggressive, so whenever I open up the enclosure and go to take her out, she looks like she's ready to eat. So one trick that I do to let her know that I'm not feeding her is I just spray down her enclosure and I spray her. Immediately when I spray her, she just goes into flight mode, wants to get away, and then I can just pick her up and I never have a problem. Once she's out, she's very, very calm, and I'm literally just her warm tree, and she just adventures around just like this. I've never had any issues with her. So I think that they're just amazing snakes. From what I hear from other people, theirs are very, very, oh, she's giving me kisses. She gives me kisses in every single video. But anyway, I find that most snakes, just like the Brazilian rainbow boas, are very, very calm in demeanor and very nice. Not really known to bite unless it's a baby. And again, they can tame right down and get out of that little attitude. So I hope that this was helpful. Let me know if you have any questions. I would love to try and help you. And thank you so much for watching, and have a wonderful day.